Hello everyone, this is Padmaja. Welcome to Vegam Saral Math. Today, in this video, I'm going to teach you how to find out perfect square roots in seconds. So let me screen share. Okay, so before starting, let's see the conventional math square root method by division. Okay, so this method, it takes so much of time, around 5 minutes to finish, and sometimes if the students are stuck, then it takes even more time than that. Let's see what can be the smart way of getting the perfect square roots. So to get the perfect square roots in seconds, so you should just know 1 square to 10 square values. Anyway, we are familiar with the first 10 tables. So 1 square to 10 square we can do, but from 1 square to 10 square, if you observe, there is a pattern. The pattern here is 1 square is ending with 1's place 1, and again you can see here 9 square is ending with 1's place 1. Okay, so 1 square and 9 square are ending with 1, and 2 square and 8 square, they are both ending with 4. Right now, 3 square and 7 square, they are both ending with 9. 4 square, 6 square are ending with 6. 5 square is ending with 5. And we can observe here, this 1 plus 9 are summing up to 10. 2 plus 8 sums up to 10. 3 plus 7, 4 plus 6, 5 plus 5 also sum up to 10. So this is the pattern in 1 square to 10 square, which we have to use in finding the perfect square roots. And one more point is, always the perfect square roots ends with 1's place 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, 9. Suppose if any number is ending with, let's say it's ending with 2. So let's take 5, 6, 2, 2. Okay, so it's ending with 1's place 2. So then we cannot find the perfect square root for that number. We can get the imperfect square root. Okay, so today what we are going to learn is how to find out the perfect square roots in seconds. So let's see some questions. Okay, so I'll take a question. 529. So we have to make 2 digits a group. So 29, I will make one group, and 5 alone, I'll make one group. So you can just write a 0 so that even this group also includes 2 digits. So we have to basically make group of 2 digits starting from the right side. Okay, so if we are making 2 groups, then the square root of this number, we should get 2 digits as our answer. The square root of 529, it should give 2 digits in the answer because it has 2 groups. So to get the first digit, to get the 1's place digit in our answer, we should see the 1's place digit. Okay, so 529 is ending with 9. So in which squares usually they end with 9? 3 square and 7 square, they end with 9. So for 529, the 1's place, they should be 3 or 7. Are you understanding? So 529 is ending with 9, and 3 and 7 squares are also ending with 9. So our 1's place answer can be 3 or 7. Okay. So then you have to see the 5 number. 5 number is coming between which 2 squares? Okay. 5 is coming between 2 square and 3 square. Okay, so we have to pick the small digit. 2 is a small digit. So here it is 2. So now we have 2 choices, 23 or 27. The square root of 529, so it can be 23 or 27. So to come out of these confusion, 2 possibilities we have, so we should pick only 1. So for that, usually 25 comes between 23 and 27, right? 25 comes between 23 and 27. So we will find out 25 times 25. So 25 times 25 answer is 625. So this trick I'll explain in other video. okay, as of now I'm just directly using the trick and getting the answer. So 25 times 25 is 625. So our question 529 is less than 625. So that's the reason we have to pick 23. So square root of 529 is 23. So this 529, because it is less than 625, which is actually 25 square. So we have two choices, right? 23 square and 27 square. So our question is less than this. So our answer should be 23 square. So I am writing 2. So let's see one more question. You have to find out square root of 361. So what is the procedure? So we have to make two digits as one group starting from the right side. So for 3, you can just write a 0 and make this as one group. So here two groups you got. So definitely the square root of 361 is going to have two digits in the answer. This is a ones place digit. So to get the ones place digit answer, you have to see the ones place only. So which squares are ending with ones place 1? Ones place 1, 1 square and 9 square are ending with ones place 1. So that's how we predict the ones place. It can be 1 or 9. You can observe here 1 and 9 are summing up to 10. Okay. So now 3 number. 3 number is coming between which squares? 3 number is coming between 1 and 2. 3 is coming between 1 square and 2 square. So I have to pick the small digit. So 1. So I'll pick 1. So now we got two options. The square root of 361. So it can be 11 or it can be 90. Okay. So we have to pick some number which comes in between, which is 15. See, the square root, it can be, our answer can be 11 or 16. And you have to find out 15 square, because 15 comes in between 11 and 19. So 15 square, the answer is 225. Answer is 225. So 361, which is our question, is greater than 225, right? So 371 is greater than 15 square. So then definitely it should be 19 square. We have two options. In the two options, we are able to decide because 19 square is 361, because this is greater than 15 square. So square root of 361 equals 19. Okay. So I'll just give some more questions. So you can do it for yourself for practice. So you can have square root of 324, one question. And second question, you can have square root of 2025. Third question, square root of 3721, and fourth question, you can have a square root of 529. Fine. So practice these questions on your own. So I hope you like this trick. Thank you for watching video. Happy math learning.